am I supposed to open these? Ah, now I've got it. There we go. Okay, that's opened that way back up. Or this side of that one up. And that's where I came in.
Ever since I got put in charge of the Panopticon, people treat me different, like I'm crazy for wanting to work with altered items. People just don't understand the altered items like I do, you know? I don't want to brag, but it does take a very empathetic mind to connect with the items.
Doesn't want to brag. Right.
Never start again. So that one must open up after I've cleared out the one I'm doing. Or the one on the left now. The last one. This one.
People are making it so personal. I mean, the teams in research handle paranatural materials every day, and no one thinks they're weird. Well, maybe that's not true. Darling is famous for being a bit out there, but when he's weird, it's charming. Altered items really aren't that frightening once you get to know them. If you figure out what they like or don't like, you know, sets them off.
He's definitely repeating himself.
I guess at the end of the day, we're still just scared of our own. We're supposed to be on the same team, but sometimes it feels like it's every department for themselves.
Of course, weapon mods again. These ones are full as well. No, that one. Thank you. so bright, I keep having to look away from the screen to do it. Arcade cabinet's procedures. A distance of 10 feet between the items suppresses their effect. Effect only triggers on physical contact. Description: altered effect. Items are a pair of arcade game cabinets originally designed for the games Shoom and Shoom 2. Colga's Revenge. The games were manufactured by Bonco Entertainment, now out of business. Despite being a popular arcade game in Japan during the late 80s, early 90s, no other Shoom cabinets have been found by our investigators. When touching one of the items, while it stands within 10 feet of its counterpart, the user's mind is transported to a version of their subjective reality that resembles a video game in logic and function. Events from their everyday lives become game-like sequences in which speed and efficacy are paramount. The brain enters a stroke-like state, as proven by EEG studies on users, which only ends after the user finishes their game, at which point they resume normal brain and motor functions. Okay. Okay, the light broke. I need to find another light. Didn't I leave a light upside down right here? That one's reappeared, so that's good. Pity their metal bars, I can't. He's in there again. Damn it. He was just here. Can I do it that way? Doesn't look like I can. Actually, I turned the light on that. But it doesn't seem to have done anything. I can't move it. There's one that's not lit up, not. Lit. That's just the way I came into the room. No, I can't get that one again. Damn it. I think this is the way forward. There's still things maybe I've lost my chance, but I wanted to get that too. Maybe I can. There we go. Escape the darkened corridor. Now, where does that box go? Ow. There. Okay, so that's all the darkened corridor was. Not much in there for me, though.